Good morning, everyone. My topic of paper presentation today is effect of heparinized irrigating solution during cataract surgery on postoperative inflammation. My paper presentation code is FP722. No financial interest. Techniques of extracapsular cataract extraction have changed over the years. Earlier, it was conventional method, then manual SICS, then phaco emulsification, now femto laser assisted cataract extraction. Intraocular surgery is an ocular trauma. There is breakdown of blood aqueous barrier and release of prostaglandin. Postoperative inflammation continues to be a cause of patient's pain and discomfort. Suboptimal visual acuity following postoperative inflammation may be due to cystoid macular edema. Heparin is a well-known anticoagulant. Apart from being anticoagulant, it is also anti-inflammatory and has anti-proliferative effects. It inhibits fibrin formation after intraocular surgery and also shown to inhibit fibroblast activity, hence reducing postoperative inflammation. The rationale for our study was there were various studies in the Western countries that showed heparin will reduce postoperative inflammation. However, though this modification is simple without any extra expenditure, we wanted to see the results in Indian population where the iris were highly pigmented. Our aim was to evaluate the role of heparin in reducing postoperative inflammation in cataract surgery. Objectives were to document postoperative inflammation and cellular reaction after cataract surgery, to grade and compare the severity of inflammation and cellular reaction with heparin and without heparin, and to document any complication arising after using heparin. Study was conducted in our department and done by a single experienced surgeon under standard condition. This was a hospital-based cohort study since we had follow-up. The sample size was 60 eyes in each group. There were two groups. All the patients admitted for cataract surgery after analyzing from exclusion and inclusion criteria were randomized into two groups. Group one, 60 patients who underwent cataract surgery with heparinized irrigating solution, and group two containing 60 patients undergoing cataract surgery without heparinized irrigating solution, that is plain balanced salt solution. The inclusion criteria was patients of age group around 30 years or more undergoing cataract surgery, the cause of vision loss being cataract. Exclusion criteria, patients with ocular disease like uveitis and glaucoma, complicated cataract, history of ocular surgeries or trauma in the past, patients with pseudo-exfoliation and posterior synechiae, patients who are on pilocarpine therapy, patients with bleeding tendencies and known history of using systemic anticoagulants, and patients not consenting to study. After taking institutional ethical committee clearance and consent from each patient, patients were subjected to surgery. During surgery, group one patients received heparinized irrigating solution. 5 ml of heparin containing 5,000 units were added to 500 ml of balanced salt solution. And the second group received plain balanced salt solution. All the patients underwent cataract extraction by phaco emulsification by a single experienced surgeon using superior clear corneal incision using 2.8 mm keratome. Postoperatively, patients were assessed on day 1, day 15, day 28, and 8 weeks. Visual acuity, inflammatory reaction using slit lamp examination for assessment of anterior chamber cells, flare, and pigment dispersion. Postoperative, if any complications arise, were noted. This was how it was done. 5 fields were selected, and then using 1 mm into 1 mm oblique slit lamp beam, anterior chamber cells, flare, and pigments were recorded. For data analysis, statistical analysis was done using chi-square test, Mann-Whitney U-test, Wilcoxon signed rank test, and the software used were SPSS 24.0 version and GraphPad Prism 7.0 version. Coming to the results, in our study, the maximum people belong to age group of 61 to 70 years. And in group where heparin was used, male were 70% and female contributed to 30%. However, in patients where heparin was not used, there was equal distribution of gender. Coming to anterior chamber cells, when we compare patients who received heparin and who did not receive heparin, we can see that in the immediate post-operative period, that is on day 1 and day 15, it shows statistically significant values indicating that patients who received heparin had significantly less reaction. However, on late postoperative days, that is on day 28 and 8 weeks, it was not significant. Similar trends were seen in anterior chamber flare and iris pigment dispersion also, indicating early postoperative reaction was quite less when heparin was used. Postoperative inflammation is mainly because of surgical trauma to blood aqueous barriers and release of prostaglandins. In order to reduce bias, all the surgeries were conducted by a single surgeon and the techniques were standardized. Since in SICS, there is some amount of iris handling, it could act as a confounding factor in our study, and hence we resorted to phacoemulsification only. Study by Dandona et al. Showed that heparin prevents production of reactive oxygen species by leukocyte, hence reducing inflammation. All these have led to the invention of heparin-coated IOLs, which are used in pediatric surgery and in patients with uveitis, cystic uveitis, so that there is lesser postoperative reaction. Studies by Kruger et al. Also showed that heparin, when used in a concentration of 10 international units per ml, reduced postoperative inflammation. Various studies have been conducted. Another study is Yasser Iqbal et al., who also concluded that using heparin will reduce early postoperative inflammation. In our study, no intraoperative complications such as iris bleeding, etc., were encountered. So we can safely say that using heparin at a concentration of 10 international units per ml is quite safe for intraocular surgeries. Similar results were also achieved in a study conducted by Kruger et al. Hence, we can conclude that to implement heparin in irrigating patients to reduce postoperative inflammatory reaction.
Sir, I would like to interrupt you. The time is up, so we'll be now going ahead for the question and answers.
Okay, ma'am.
We have 6 minutes for everyone, for all the presenters. So now we'll move ahead for the judges' question and answer.
Sure, ma'am.
Okay, only one comment I would like to make. Nice presentation, but you need to stick to time, especially in international and national presentation, and especially if it is a competitive presentation.
I'll improve on that, sir.
Yeah, I agree with Dr. Paul. It's very important, especially in international conferences.
Because you will get a lot of marks deducted in any international presentation if you not stick to time.
Yeah, at least 1/4 of marks. So, Abhishek?
Yes, sir.
Did you find any reduction in the tasks?
Actually, sir, because of the time he has exceeded 8 minutes, I think we will not be able to...
Yes. And he will not be evaluated as well because he is a non-notified member. I think he knows it.
Yes,
Abhishek,
sir.
He will not be judged.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Thank you. Thank